character in this game does not represent all people with depression. Please note, there may be triggering material within the game. Make sure to take breaks if necessary. It feels like no matter what, the end of one tunnel is the start of another. Which would be the greater suffering, to remain in this endless loop, or to find an exit that's just as meaningless? If there's no means of escape, what's the point of moving forward? Thank you.
Let's rehearse.
I have to tell
her. I'm unhappy. Okay. I'm unhappy. I'm unhappy.
Why is this so heavy? They're only words, but somehow they're not coming out. What's with these thoughts? Okay, I'm ready.
Wait!
She's just being polite. There's no need to bother her. If you answer the question for real, they'll think you're weird. There's no point in making her worry. She can't help me anyway. We often dwell on trivial things. So our efforts soon go down the drain, again and again. On occasion, we may be willing to open up our hearts. But when we hide our true selves, it feels like people barely notice. Okay, I got this. Keep going, nearly there. Leave me alone. Let me concentrate. Concentrate. How is this so hard for you? Why does this keep happening? I just want to do well. All these lingering doubts don't just interfere with our concentration at work. They impact our core confidence in all that we do, in ourselves, and in our futures. Over and over, we live our days like this, until finally, we lose everything. This segment was just a representation of having depressive emotions and feelings. You may have felt this way before, too. Did you think depression was simply about having extreme thoughts? Too heavy. I need to take some stuff out. What am I gonna do? If I fail, Dad will be furious. Why can't I keep my focus? I wish you both every happiness. Belle, I've been so empty since you left. Mom, where are you? When are you gonna come back? I didn't manage to finish my work today, even though I don't have anything to do when I get back home. There's nothing else left inside the bag. Why is it still so heavy? The metaphor of the bag. The burden couldn't be attributed to anything within because the heaviness was within the bag itself. There is no logical way to explain depression. Even so, we seek out reasons for the unhappiness. Perhaps it was a breakup or an issue with our studies. It hurts to be perceived as someone with a mental disorder because we don't want society to label us as oversensitive or even crazy because we're too emotional. But by doing this, we invite those around us to try to solve the symptoms rather than get to the root of the issue. At the end of the day, we're left only with a lack of satisfaction, and our depression lingers.
Let me see. I like... This isn't what I want. Let's try something else.
I want a burger with lettuce, tomato, and pineapple. Okay, that's what I want. I'm stuffed. Why can't I even finish one burger? We can taste things and tell if they're good. But eating won't make us feel content or happy,
no matter how much we consume. Sometimes we even feel ashamed by our appetite. What makes you happy?
That's probably the trickiest question of all to answer. Who's holding the camera? Is it on a tripod? Huh, their cat isn't in this. My cousin graduated before I even realized.
fit enough to go hiking at that age. How nice. Maybe I should get breakfast at Fellow's Cafe tomorrow. She's put on some weight. She shouldn't be old enough to care about that. Every day is the same. Things repeat themselves day after day. Time flies. She's all grown up now, but I'm still living the same life. Days repeat like turning wheels. 10 years, 20 years, 30 years. The repetition isn't even the most terrifying part. It's the fact that I can't see the end.
If there's no means of escape, what's the point of moving forward?
Go to sleep and don't think about anything. Stop thinking. Focus on sleeping. Thank you. stop thinking about it, no matter how hard I try. I fall asleep when I don't want to, but I can't sleep when I need to. The more I worry about not falling asleep, the harder it gets. The more I want to control my mind, the harder it becomes. There are plenty of things like this in life. It's so frustrating. Anyone could be suffering from depression.
This game is designed to place players into the shoes of someone living with depression. Rather than thinking about the symptoms, we invite you to focus on feeling. We hope this experience can provide some helpful insight if there is someone in your life who has depression.
I think I should be laughing at this. I can see it coming. Should I just laugh along? This movie feels like it'll never end. I feel so dissociated sometimes. The world seems distant. We don't want to spoil everyone's fun at parties, so we pretend to be normal and act like everyone else. Let me check today's messages. I I don't really want to do anything, but I'll just go work out. There's nothing I want to eat. I'll just get takeout. Another boring day. Let's check my messages. Luna. It can't be. Luna. How? Depression isn't exclusive to introverts. It has nothing to do with mental strength either. Anyone could be suffering from depression. Show your care for everyone, even those who seem outgoing and talkative. Does it sound absurd to you? Perhaps. But it's a true story. Sometimes, bad news comes out of the blue. Many don't seem depressed, and it's not until they commit suicide that others realize just how bad it was for them. Can things like that be prevented? To be honest, I don't know. Boss gave us a week off. We'd better find something to do. Did Luna do that because I lied to her? Ugh, stop thinking about it. If I'd been nicer to her, maybe she wouldn't have. No, I need to focus on the cake. Was I a bad friend? Had I noticed what was going on with Luna? Stop thinking about it. I better lie down. We like to blame ourselves. Of course, even if someone else is the reason we blame ourselves, it might not be their fault. Depression drains your energy and affects your physical health. I should check my messages. When you're sick, people generally ask if you're okay. Depression is as much of a physical illness, yet people tend to overlook it. Maybe that's because the symptoms can't be seen. What is she trying to tell me? Looks like her siblings visit her at the hospital every now and then. She's telling me about the church she goes to. She told me its location and invited me to come. It's odd. I didn't reject her. Perhaps this unexpected event could change my repetitive, monotone life. Come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Rest? What does that even mean? Do they only use words that are hard to understand? And Jesus answering said unto them, They that are whole need not a physician, but they that are sick. Isn't that obvious? If in this life only we have hope in Christ, we are of all men most miserable. Wouldn't it be sad if we left nothing behind in the end? For the same cause also do ye joy. And rejoice with me. I want joy, but I really can't. What is life, really? Why do people have faith? There are a lot of things I don't understand. There's nothing I really want to do, and I have plenty of time. Maybe it's better than simply waiting to die. I should check my messages.
What's with these thoughts?
Nobody wants to be labeled mentally ill. But if we meet someone who understands us, we'll realize that the label doesn't mean anything. The sad truth is that very few are lucky enough to meet a kindred spirit. How should I put this? I can't make them think I'm abnormal. Do I seem weird for saying that? Am I going to get injections for my treatment? Will they make me lose my intelligence? What if people judge me for it? I just need to take my medication on time, and there aren't any permanent side effects. I can work and live my life as usual. It's not as scary as I'd imagined to see a social worker every month. The hardest part is working up the courage to take that first step. We tend to assume the worst, and it's these thoughts that keep us from moving forward. But the truth is that a lot of people in society are willing to help. We just have to ask. Thank you. social worker told me to find a hobby. It's easier said than done. Luna liked the fresh air, but I don't think I'm that into it. It says on the internet that music can help with depression, but I just find it hard to learn. I've been afraid of coming to this theme park ever since my mom passed away. But it's not as bad as I thought it would be. Drawing makes me calm. I think I found a new hobby. Time slowly passes. Medication and therapy have been helping me feel better. What's important is hard work and an open mind. Feels like the end of one tunnel is the start of another. Is this my... Future self? Is this the future I want? life repeats itself, but not all hope is lost. I don't much like a meaningless future, but it's still better than living in the past. Such thoughts occupy our minds all year round, and will continue to suffer from the same pain in the future. But I have learned to cope with these thoughts.
Okay, I got this.
Let me calm down. There's no need to rush. There's still time. I can do this. Let me calm down. There's no need to rush. There's still time. I can do this. It's okay if I don't finish the food. I can take the leftovers home. I don't expect the problems in my life to just go away, nor do I need to deal with them. we might be weaker than others in some aspects. Learning to accept yourself is a lifelong lesson. I should stop playing with my phone and start drawing. This is my favorite. It doesn't look too bad. I still remember what you looked like. All right, let me draw another one. I'm tired. Better take a break. Technology sometimes causes relative deprivation, pressure, and self-pity. But other technology, like ambient music, online communities, and medication, help to alleviate our pain. I've reached the next chapter of my life, and there's someone by my side. Sometimes I think about how I used to hold no hope for the future.
I realize that I deserve happiness too. Reality isn't like the movies. There isn't a beginning and an end. Pain and loneliness may never go away. Dreams are painful. But without them, I would be no different to a walking, talking zombie. My dreams have kept me alive, so I can stand here and tell you not to give up. You know what? Simply being alive is incredible enough.